Okay, let's see. New music? Yep. New Minecraft update? Mm-hmm. New season of the Bedrock Guide? Let's go! Alright folks, we don't have any time to waste. We are gonna go ahead and get started on day one. In our brand new Minecraft world, 1.18 has finally arrived. Minecraft will never be the same. I mean, just take a look at this place. Good grief, the terrain here is amazing. It's so cool. We've got mountains, we've got caves, we've got valleys, we've got all sorts of stuff in Minecraft Caves and Cliffs Part 2. But let's talk about that later on. First, we need to talk about what to do to survive your first night in a Minecraft world. We are going to prepare for darkness. And how we're going to prepare for darkness is doing exactly what we've just done. We're gonna punch a tree. We're gonna get some logs. You need wood. It is the most essential first resource in the game. We've already got a drowned down there. Hopefully he's not going to attack us. But we need wood. We need tools. We need armor. We need all sorts of things. We need a crafting table first and foremost. So let's get away from the water a little bit. We're gonna come over here. We're gonna grab some wood. We'll place a log in our crafting inventory and we'll get four planks. And then we'll place all four of those planks right back in and get our first crafting table. Then we'll go ahead and place it down on the ground, and what we need to do is go ahead and craft up some planks. And with those planks, we'll go ahead and craft up some sticks. And with those sticks, we will get the most iconic tool in all of Minecraft, the pickaxe. We've got our wooden pickaxe, and that's going to aid us very well here soon. And then we're going to go ahead and craft up an axe. An axe is the second most important tool that you can get on day one because it serves a dual purpose. It will help you chop down more trees, and it'll help you chop down more mobs. That's how you're going to protect yourself early on. We may end up upgrading this axe before the sun goes down, but we're going to go ahead and get some of this stone right here. We're gonna try not to destroy too much of this terrain because it is pretty nice. We want to leave it looking really, really cool, but we need to get a few different resources. This right here, coal included, can be mined with any pickaxe. Coal is very important. It is the fuel source of Minecraft, especially early on, and this will help us get food. It'll help us get torches. It'll help us smelt items like iron. There are a lot of different things that you need on day one in order to survive the night, and we're gonna do our best not to sleep through the night. We may not even have a choice. If we can't find sheep, we're not going to get a bed, and then we won't be able to sleep through the night. One thing about wooden tools is that they are very slow, and they break very easily. So we're going to go ahead and upgrade really quick. We're going to grab a stone pickaxe, and let's just go ahead and grab a stone axe as well. We'll retire the wooden axe. We might use it for things a little bit later if needed. It'll be our backup axe. We need to keep an eye on time, because a Minecraft day is about 10 minutes long, and so we run the risk of running into darkness if we are not careful. And we don't want to be caught out in the middle of the dark without any protection. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to jump up here to the mountains really quick and see if we can spot any iron exposed. If not, we're not going to worry about it. We'll try to get that after dark. Do I see any iron exposed to the air? I don't. So let's move on. We might have better luck finding it somewhere else. This is a very good sign right there. We've got a village over there. In season one of the Bedrock Guide, we avoided villages on day one at all costs, just to show the experience in case you weren't able to find a village. I know that's not the case for everybody. We are going to use this village to our advantage. So we're going to work our way over there. I have scouted this area out, just to be transparent with you guys, ahead of time. We haven't done a ton with it. I haven't gone anywhere beyond the immediate spawn location, and we haven't looked underground, and we haven't found any like diamonds or anything. We haven't found anything like the stronghold or the end portal or anything like that. So we're flying blind here. But this is very important. We've got sugarcane. Sugarcane is useful for things like paper, so that later on we can get some books for enchantments, and we can also get things like rockets. Rockets are an obsession of mine. You need rockets for flight, which we cannot do just yet, but later on in the season, we'll have lots of fun flying around. Again, let me explain this axe really quick. The reason why we decided to go with an axe over a sword is because there's honestly not much damage difference between the two, and we are limited on resources at this point in the game, so we don't want to burn through too many. So for example, an unenchanted wooden sword deals 2 hearts of damage, and an unenchanted wooden axe deals a heart and a half of damage, so it's not really worth the extra effort to get both an axe and a sword, and you'll get dual purpose out of the axe. Here we've got a village. We've got villagers. We've got an iron golem to protect from mobs at night. That might be a good strategy. Of course, we're going to go ahead and take some potatoes. And like a good Minecraft world person, we're going to go ahead and replant some of these potatoes so our farmers at the village are not mad at us. That'll get us enough to get going. Then we're going to go ahead and take some of these carrots right here as well, because these are a great day one source of food. They do not require any fuel to cook the carrots. You can eat them raw. Carrots, a great way to go. The sun is over halfway through the sky and we are running out of daylight, so I want to try to make my way over to where we're going to be camping for the night. I haven't found any sheep just yet, so unfortunately, no bed. Let me look around for just a couple of minutes to see if we can find any sheep. If you're new or returning to Minecraft, we have various mobs in the overworld. These are cows, obviously. They will give you steak and leather. They are passive. They do not attack you. And there are different mobs like sheep and pumpkins. Let's grab some pumpkins. These will be useful for later on. We don't need too many, so we won't take them all. As you're wandering around, I know this is a lot of information to soak in. We will go into more depth in future episodes, but day one is always kind of a mishmash of everything that you just stumble upon. This is an abandoned nether portal, and we're gonna be careful of that, because I'm not dying day one, Prowl. We're gonna go in here, and there's not really much in here that's helpful to us. Golden sword? Maybe? We'll go ahead and take it. It's got smite on it. Smite is an enchantment. We'll talk more about enchantments in the future, but smite is actually useful against undead mobs. So we might make use of this at night when zombies come out. It does deal more damage to things like zombies and skeletons. So we will reserve that for those guys. And I am just ever so shocked. I have not seen any sheep yet. Where are all the sheep at? Way over there, we've got a spruce forest. And then I believe kind of off in the distance over there, we've got a birch forest. We have quite a bit of terrain variety around this location. There's a lot to deal with. And we're going to find our way over to where my main location is going to be to start this world out. Okay, good. We've got some sheep here. And hopefully, we'll be able to take them down and get three wool. We've got one. Please, guy, please. Can I have three wool? It's about to get dark. It's about to get scary. I don't want to be out here for very much longer. We need to get a few more trees and get indoors, because it is about to get dark. We have some things to do, not to prepare for darkness anymore, because darkness is here. The sun is going down. The scary things are about to come out. We have not found any iron yet, so we are unprotected. We don't have any armor. We don't have a shield. We don't have anything. We're just going to leave the rest of that tree there, and we're just going to do our best to survive the darkness. Let's go. We're going to risk it for the biscuit, all right? We've only got two wool. We're going to go over here, and we're going to find another sheep. I did see one off in the distance. There he is. Please give me some wool, buddy. Please. There we go. We can finally craft the bed, but we are not going to make use of the bed just yet. That mountain way over there, that is going to be our main base area. And on top of this hill over here, that's about where we're going to set up camp for the first night. So we need to make sure to avoid any kind of mobs. There's some drowned down there. They are very, very dangerous, especially if they have tridents. Tridents are one of the most powerful weapons in the game. Actually, in the unenchanted form, tridents deal the most damage out of any weapon in Minecraft, including the sword. So tridents are nothing to mess around with, especially if you have no armor. So we need to be very careful. If we hear anything creeping along, if we see anything coming our way, we need to run. I hear a spider. Spiders are dangerous at night. They don't bother you during the day, but at nighttime, they get very, very dangerous. They get very, very angry, and there's a skeleton. Let's just go the other way, shall we? I would not advise doing this if you don't have to, but unfortunately, we've kind of had to make our own bed here. I heard a zombie, and we're just going to keep on going. I'll be honest with you guys. I'm a little scared. I don't want to die on day one, and there's a pretty good chance of that. We do have a death counter. Just saw a creeper, by the way. We do have a death counter in our world this season, starting day one, so I will not be able to hide that from you. If I die, you're going to know it. All I got to do is go to the pause menu, and we'll be able to show you as soon as a death comes up onto the screen. It's not available right now because nobody's died yet. If Prowl dies on day one, oh, it's going to be a good day. It's going to be a good day. I don't think it's going to happen. We're both being pretty cautious. There's a zombie. Let's get out of here. There's another one. And we'll just kind of bob and weave and find our way over in this general direction. Oh, my gosh. Oh, my hunger's out. My hunger's out. We're in trouble. Oh, we're in trouble. This is probably a good time to mention that you should stay calm on day one. Don't freak out. There's a lot to focus on day one, and here's what we're going to do. We're going to go ahead and whack-a-doodle. We're going to take these guys out. Like I told you, Smite. Smite does a lot more damage to undead mobs, and so if we see any coming our way, we're going to go ahead and pull out the golden sword, and we'll be just fine. My next goal, honestly, right now, is to get underground. And I think this is a good spot over here to do it. We are not going to go too far underground. We're going to be very careful with how far down we go because we're not trying to go caving. We are trying to go mining, but we're not trying to go caving. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to craft up a shovel really quick so that we can get through some of this dirt without any hassle. You can dig dirt with your hand or with a pickaxe or with a sword or anything else, and it will go relatively quickly, but nothing is faster for digging dirt than a shovel. These are important things to know so that you can survive on day one. Now, when we get a little bit lower down here, we're going to go ahead and craft up some torches so that we can light the area up. One of the new Minecraft changes in 1.18 is that mobs will no longer spawn unless the area is in absolute darkness. So what that means for us is we have to do far less lighting up of our area in order to prevent mobs from spawning down here. So I'm going to go ahead and craft up 8 torches, and we're going to go 1, 2, 3. This area is pretty dark, so we're going to light that up. We're just going to light up this whole general area so that we can make sure that nothing can sneak up on us, and we're pretty safe. We have walls all the way around us at this point, so this basically serves as some level of a shelter. Even though we're outdoors still, we are still protected. That is a huge, huge thing that you need to do for yourself on day one, is find a space that you can be protected. But what we're going to do now is, while it's dark, we're going to light this area up, and we're going to go looking for some iron. Iron is the next resource that we want. We're going to be very careful of those guys over there. We can already spot them from a mile away. If we can find some iron, that means we can get some protection. Good grief, that place is huge. Wow! Look at it. Oh no. Do you see that over there? We do not want to mess around with that. It's dark. I don't know if you can see it. I see the tippy top of the hat. That is a witch. And witches are not to be trifled with, especially if you have no armor. We are not going anywhere near that. We're going to go this direction and hope, again, that we can find some iron. This guy right here is a zombie variant. It is a zombified villager. If you find these guys in the middle of the night, you can convert them to villagers, which we will talk about how to do that in a later episode. We need to be very careful because we're about to die. Oh boy. No! No! We are not going to die on day one. I mean, we might die on day one, but we're not going to die on day one. It's going to be fine. We're going to be okay. I'm going to venture down a little bit farther down into this cave, and I hope we stumble upon some iron here soon, because I am getting a little nervous. Hey, we found it. This is copper. We don't need that yet. We want iron. So we're going to go ahead and mine that. You do have to mine it with a stone pickaxe. One piece of iron is not going to do us a whole lot of good. There's some more iron right there. We'll grab that. We'll make sure to watch our back. Oh, we broke our sword. That's bad. Okay, that's fine. We'll just have to be more careful. All right, our zombie friends are taken care of. We've checked our backs. There's no creepers around. Let's go ahead and get this iron. Let's see if we can get a little bit more. We got 3 pieces of iron so far. Anybody else? Anybody else around here? The other thing that I'm not really aware of is what time of day it is, because we are below ground. So if we have survived the cave experience on day one, we might have survived our first night in a Minecraft world. So things that you might want to keep in mind, if it is daylight back up top, we have plenty of time to come back down here when it gets dark again, or we can sleep through the night and gather some more materials up top. So some things that we might want to gather, we might want to get some leather. Leather armor is going to be very, very important for Caves and Cliffs Part 2, because leather boots will actually get you safely up and down the mountainous terrain. If you don't have leather boots on, you're going to struggle a little bit, because there is a snowier snow in this update. We've got powdered snow, which makes you sink down into it and you start taking freezing damage, and it'll just make pretty quick work of you if you're not careful. And look at that! It's daylight! We survived the first night! Woo! I was a little bit nervous that we weren't going to, but you know what? We made the right moves, and now you can say that you know how to defeat the darkness. You just run and hide in a hole in the ground. I learned that from Prowl last year. Now that I've found sheep, I feel like I can't stop finding sheep. I can't find anything but sheep. Where are all the cows? I need cows. Well, I was hoping to find some cows, but unfortunately I haven't been able to find any in the last several minutes, so we're going to carry on, and I want to show you a few more things that you can do to help survive your first night in your new Minecraft world. We set up shop down here in this little ravine, and what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and craft up a campfire. In order to craft a campfire, you need 3 logs, you need 3 sticks in a triangle, and then you need one coal. When you've got a campfire, you have unlimited access to as much food as you can cook. So we don't need to worry about wasting fuel. We can just place our food on the campfire and it'll cook right up for us. When you place a campfire, it will light automatically, so we don't need to worry about that. So we're gonna go ahead and go boom, 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 and boom, and we've got four pork chops on the campfire. That'll take just a little bit to cook, and then once they are done, they will pop right off and we can pick them up and keep going. The next thing that we want to do is craft up a furnace, which can be crafted with cobblestone in a square, leaving the middle slot empty. We can go ahead and do that. As you can hear, that just popped off of there and into our inventory. We'll go ahead and put down four more pork chops, and then we will go ahead and put our furnace down nearby our crafting table. We don't need to use this for cooking food right now, but we can go ahead and put this in there, and we can smelt our iron. Once we have smelted this raw iron, it will give us an iron ingot, which we can do several things with. Be careful of campfires, though, because you might catch yourself on fire, and that's not a good idea. Once we have iron ingots, we can go into our crafting table, and we can take six planks and go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like an American football goalpost, and then we can place one iron straight up in the middle there, and we've got our first shield. This is our first line of defense. You can hold it in your main hand, or you can hold it in your offhand. I would suggest holding it in your offhand so you can use other things. With your shield in hand, if you press the crouch button, it will raise the shield directly in front of you, and with that shield directly in front of you, if you come up along any mobs that might be able to punch you, hit you with a sword, shoot you with a bow and arrow, even a creeper explosion, you'll get some protection from those things. Still not a replacement for armor, but it's a start. And because we were unable to find any kind of leather for armor, we're not really going to be able to craft any armor right now, except maybe... Here we go. We've got enough iron left over that we can get one set of iron boots, and that will at least give us some level of protection for when we fall or when we're attacked. So now that it's getting dark again, we need to think about our strategy going forward, and the best strategy is to avoid darkness altogether. We've got our bed, and then I'm going to go in here, and I'm going to take one of these blue flowers that we found, because I always do this on day one, and we've got ourselves a blue bed with some blue dye, and we're going to place that bed down right there. Now that it's dark, there's no mobs around, bada bing, bada boom, we're going to sleep. And it's daytime. We don't have to worry about any of the mobs coming out. We've avoided that altogether. If I could have done that day one, I definitely would have. So just a quick recap of everything that we covered today. The first thing you need to do is get some supplies, starting with some wood. And once you've got some wood, you can get a crafting table and you can craft up all of your tools. And once you have those things, you can go find some food, and then you can find some shelter and get some protection. And then you're free to wander about your Minecraft world and head off into a new adventure. That's what we're about to do. We're going to jump into episode 2 here shortly, where we're going to be getting our food sources a little bit more stable. So check it out. Episode 2. It's going to be all about farming. I hope you guys are as excited as I am for Bedrock Guide Season 2. Let's hit that end credits music, and we will roll on into Episode 2 very soon.